everybody, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, hi, my name is Tristan, and today I'm going to be doing a video about 10 things that I wish that I knew before applying to college. So, if you're like me, then you are applying to college and you're the first one in your family to go through this process. So I had to go through a lot of learning pains, and I want to make this easier for you guys because YouTube videos and everything else helped me so much. So I want to be able to help you guys. So these are things that I wish I had known and some things that my friends told me that they wish that they knew before applying. And if you guys have any other tips or things that you wish that you had known if you already applied to college, then please leave them in the comments below. It really helps people. So let's get started. The first thing that we're gonna go through is when to take the SAT or ACT and which test to take. So this one was really important for me. In the area that I live in, pretty much everyone takes the SAT. That's the big test around here. There isn't a lot of focus on the ACT. However, when I took the ACT, I realized that it was easier for me. Like, it would have been a lot easier if I had studied. It was just kind of too late for me by the time that I took it. So I was stuck with the SAT, which really just was not a good test for me. So it's important to research into what each test asks of you to do. For example, the ACT has a science section while the SAT does not. So if you're good at science, you might want to take the ACT. So before you take the test, I would definitely research into which one would probably be better for you, or just try both and see which one you like more. And then secondly, when to take the test. So for me at my school, they really emphasize start taking your SAT standardized test during the springtime of your junior year. However, I totally 100% wish that I had taken it earlier than that. Because by the time that springtime rolled around, it was a really busy time of the year for me. Like, AP tests were coming up, my classes started to get more difficult, my extracurriculars, it just all at once, everything was happening. So I wish I had taken it earlier. I think it would be good to start studying for the SAT, definitely your sophomore year. And if you want to, you should take it maybe towards the end of your sophomore year rather than the middle of your junior year. That's what I would recommend doing. Okay, tip number two. Oh, I wish that I had known that it's okay to do different things, like diversify your interests and extracurriculars. So what I mean by this is that I was super interested in science. I really loved biology and I thought that I wanted to be a doctor, but I did different activities involving civil rights and just human rights, and I really, really got interested in those things. And it made me realize maybe I don't want a career in medicine, and it also really helped me find new things that I never would have known about that I was super interested in. So I think it's important to do things that revolve around the career that you might want to have or the subject that you might want to study, but also just do different things because you never know what you're going to end up liking. It's cool if you're into bio to do an internship at a lab, but maybe try volunteering with a local humanitarian group. You really never know what you'll be interested in. There's so many things out there. And you never really know until you try. Number three is be a leader or a trailblazer in something that matters to you. So if you do want to apply to a top school, a really competitive school, then they are looking for people who take leadership roles. So let's say you could start a club, you could start an organization, you could start a business, you could be a co-founder, you can do so many different things. So it's important to start early, because that's what allows you to kind of move up in ranks per se. Like, I volunteered at a hospital for 4 years, and after the 1 year that I volunteered, I became a junior leader. So staying in something consistently for a long time is helpful in that. Or you can just do simple things like finding other teams in your area that are interested in the same thing. You can start an organization with them. There's a lot of things that you can do. You should just research more into that. The next thing would be looking into different financial aid sources and different scholarships. So this one is really important. When I applied to Stanford, I didn't know that there was two different types of financial aid that you had to do. There are lots of different financial aid opportunities, and especially scholarships if you get started on those early. There's ones that are offered for juniors, seniors. There's so many. and it'll really help alleviate financial stress if you have that. It's good to look into scholarships that schools offer and organizations offer as well. Oh, just a note though, you should know that scholarships, a lot of them are also very competitive. So I would definitely look into things early because there's lots of scholarships that go unused every year. So it's important to look for those little weird, obscure ones and try and get those. Number six, start building relationships with staff early. So this is so important, especially your counselor, because your counselor will write letters of recommendation for you. They can help you find scholarships. Counselors are such a good source of information. I got close with mine in my, I think my second year of high school, and it really helped having a close relationship with her, especially when I was applying to college, but she helped me so much. And also your teachers, because you will need to get letters of recommendation from them if you're applying to a school that requires letters of recommendation. So it's better that you know them well so that they can write in a way that accurately reflects who you are. Bouncing off of that, it's also important to get your letters of recommendation way in advance. I kind of waited until the last minute, and that stressed me out so much, and that stressed them out, which sucks when they're doing something really nice for you. So I would recommend thinking about that, who you want to choose, and asking them for that as early as possible. Number seven would be to set a time and date that you want to sit down with your parent or guardian and look at college stuff. Like, it's really important to have their guidance. And if you don't have a figure like that, then you can always look online. There's so many different resources, YouTube videos, but a lot of the information that you have to fill out, just the basic miscellaneous information in your college applications, you will need their help. Like, I definitely needed my mom's help. So if you're able to just plan a day, especially in advance before your application is due, like way before, then it'll take away a lot of the stress, because you want to be able to spend time on your essays and other things that matter as well. Something else would be to apply to more schools and research them more. So by this, I mean, you might get fee waivers from different schools that are interested in you. And although you think you, even if you're like almost completely sure that you don't want to go there, sometimes I think it is worth it to just apply if they're offering it for free, because you really never know what'll happen. And maybe you'll learn more about that school after you get accepted and want to go there. It's good to keep your options open. So if you have the time for that, if you want to do that, then I would apply to more schools. And also, if you're like 100% sure that you want to be a doctor, or very sure about what it is that you're passionate about and want to do in your life, you should look into different colleges for their programs that they have and see if it suits what you want to do and what resources you think that you'll need, because different colleges cater to different things. Even though most colleges do offer the same general education for undergrad, some schools do have certain programs that would be helpful in a specific field. Number nine would be, I wish that I had known to spend more time on essays and research how to write them. So this is so important. This is so important, because if you're like me and your stats aren't perfect and you're aiming for a really selective school, then your essays help make you a person rather than just a number in the eyes of the admissions officers, because they do look through thousands of applications. You really are just a number until you personalize yourself and make yourself likable. That's the ultimate goal of essays. So if you're wondering, how do I write them? It is confusing because there's no specific format or outline for college essays, but the best way to learn how to write them would be to read them. Yay! This one is called 50 Successful Stanford Application Essays. So I read this one once I decided that I wanted to go to Stanford. I was kind of late in deciding to apply, but even though I read this maybe like a month before I applied, I think I really internalized a lot of the information, and it really helped me have an idea of how I wanted to communicate in my writing. And then also, I would really recommend this one too. It's called College Essays That Made a Difference. In this book, it has a bunch of essays of people that got into different colleges. At the very back of it, it tells you what colleges they got into. So I just looked through the ones where people got into UCLA and Stanford, and it really, really did help me. I would recommend reading successful college essays, people that got accepted into the school that you might want to go to. And I wouldn't recommend writing your essay right after you read that, because like me personally, if I read something and then write right after, I do tend to kind of mimic the same style. I would read it before writing your essays, think about it a little bit, and then start writing yours. It really helps as a guideline, and it shows that there are so many different ways to write your essays, but there's also so many different ways to make it good. In terms of when to write your essays, I would always recommend doing it way beforehand, like outline 4 to 5 months before, even like 6 months, 7 months, just as early as you can start, as you feel comfortable starting. It's always good to get ahead. And it's also really important too that after you write them, get advice from people who know what successful essays look like. I asked my English teacher, who was really, really amazing, and also my counselor to look at mine, and they did help give me some really important constructive criticism. So reach out to people, draft it up, read successful essays, and then get some advice on it. And then last but not least, number 10 would be to research more, because even if you're not the first one in your family applying to college, the application process really does change just a little bit every year. It's probably different than when your parents or brother or sister applied, possibly, so it's always good to stay like with the times. And ultimately, especially if you are applying to college and you're the first one doing so in your family, there's so much information out there for you to look at. I understand that it's easy to feel really lost, because I did for a long time. It's a very confusing and long process, but there's so many different websites and so many different videos which really make it a lot easier. YouTube literally like saved my life. That's where I did a lot of my research. But there's also just different online forums. I'll try and link a few below to provide some help. But ultimately, before you apply, you definitely shouldn't go in with a blind eye. I think it's important to realistically look at where you are in terms of stats, extracurriculars, and how your essays feel, and really figure out what schools you think you can definitely get into, what schools are like maybe, and then like maybe one or two reach schools to try. Because college, getting in, sometimes it really does seem like a game, like it's so weird, it feels so random. But there is a bit of a formula to getting in. There's certain things that you can do to increase your chances. So the best thing that you can do really is to look at other people that got into schools that you want to go to, and kind of try and get advice from them, reach out. It's always, always good to reach out to other people. Okay, bye guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really, really hope that this helped. If you guys have any more video ideas or things that you want to see about college, go ahead and drop that down below in the comments. Like and subscribe. I'll see you guys soon. Okay, bye.